Okay, another thing that you might want to do whenever you're playing in MATLAB is to create like a matrix of ones or zeros. So you might need a matrix. It's, well, you know, just a whole bunch of ones. It's a thing. It's a thing that happens. Or, you know, just a whole bunch of zeros. And it could be any size that you might think it might need to be. Sometimes it's because you're starting something and you just want to start with zeros and you want to slowly add to it over time or something like that. Usually you're initializing something at ones or zeros. Well, MATLAB has a really easy way to do this. You're just going to say whatever. I guess I could have called it A, but it doesn't have to be called A. It can be called whatever you want. You can just call it ones, and you can make it a 2x2. Now, technically, you can just go 2, and it'll make it a squared, but it's so much easier just to remember to do that. Doop-de-doo. And there you go. So now we have a 2x2 matrix of ones. We can also do a matrix of zeros. So this would be a 2x4 matrix of zeros, and you can throw it together like that. So clearly, the next obvious thing is if I want a matrix of fives, that I would be like, fives, a 2x4 matrix of fives, and at that point it's gonna be like, no, you can't do that. It's really not that tough though. So if you, for example, just wanted, say, a matrix of fives, oh, it's not gonna let me do that. A matrix of, I guess I could have just done a ba-do-ba-do-ba-do. Then the idea is I could take this matrix here, oops, and I could just add five to it. if I just add five to it out here, it will add five to every single element in it. So if we want this to be C, so this won't work. This won't work. This work. But I can do C equals zeros, a 2x4 matrix, and then I can just add five to it. So then I've got my 2x4 matrix of fives. Now, another thing that I can do is instead of having a 2x4 matrix of zeros, I could have a 2x4 matrix of ones. Ah, that's not what I meant to do. 1, 1, 1, and instead of adding five, I can multiply by five. So I could do it another way, as I could do ones, a 2x4, and multiply it with five. So this is just a cute little trick just to get matrices of certain sizes of all the initial values that you might want. So you can make them all negatives, you can do really whatever you want just to get them started. This is not like a life-changing kind of way of doing things, it's just the idea that you know, sometimes you might just need a set of a matrix to, like I said, whenever you're initializing something, like we're gonna start out where everybody has five pairs of pants. So every person that these numbers represent have five pairs of pants, and that's how we set that up. So that's not too bad. Pretty good just to kind of get started. Woohoo, that was quick.